Good morning students, we learnt about CPU. This is an important lesson in your course book. This program comprises CPU. After going through this lesson, we will be able to have knowledge about CPU and knowledge about 3D printing. Images of central processing unit. The full form of CPU is called central processing unit. Once again, the full form of CPU is called central processing unit. Definition of CPU. CPU is an electronic microchip of computer which is processing the data converted to information. It is a brain of computer. It controls the computer system. Once again, CPU is an electronic microchip of computer which is processing the data converted to information. It is a brain of computer. It controls the computer system. Features of central processing unit. CPU is considered as the brain of computer. CPU perform all type of data processing operation. It stores data, intermediate result and instruction. It controls the operation of all parts of the computer. CPU has three main components. Memory unit, it is denoted by MU. Control unit, it is denoted by CU or ALU. ALU denotes arithmetic logical unit. What is memory or storage unit? This unit can store instruction data. This unit supply information to other units of computer when needed. It is also known as internal storage unit or the main memory or primary memory or random access memory. Once again, this unit can store instruction and data. This unit supply the information to other units of the computer when needed. It is also known as internal storage unit or the main memory or the primary storage or random access memory. Functions of main memory unit. It stores all data and instruction required for processing. It stores the intermediate result of processing. It stores the final result of processing before this result are released to an output device. All inputs and output are transmitted through the main memory. Once again, it stores all the data and instruction required for processing. It stores intermediate result of processing. It stores the final result of processing before the result are released to an output device. All input output are transmitted through the main memory. What is control unit? This unit controls the operation of all parts of computer. It is responsible for controlling the transfer of data instruction among other units of computer. It manages and coordinates all the units of the computer. It obtains the instruction from the memory and directs the operation of the computer. Once again, this unit controls the operation of all parts of the computer. It is responsible for controlling the transfer of data and instruction among other units of computer. It manages and coordinates all the units of a computer. It obtains the instruction from the memory and directs the operation of the computer. Control unit uses. It communicates with input or output device for transfer of data or result from storage. It does not process or stores data. ALU. ALU stands for Arithmetic Logical Unit. Arithmetic. The function of arithmetic section is to perform arithmetic operation like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. All complex operation are done by making repetitive use of the above operation. Logic. The function of logical section is to perform logical operations such as comparing, selecting, matching and merging of data. Once again, functions of arithmetic section is to perform arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. All complex operations are done by making repetitive use of the above operation. Logic. Function of logic section is used to perform logic such as comparing. Comparing is comparing two numbers. Selecting, matching and merging of data. The CPU is otherwise known as microprocessor. CPU stands for central processing unit. The CPU is one of the most component within a computer system. The CPU is also alternatively referred to as a processor or central processor or a microprocessor. The CPU that actually provides the processing power to the computer. The CPU works at the lightning speed and perform millions of calculations per second in order to execute any program. CPU. The CPU is said to be the brain of computer system where all the arithmetic calculation and logical operation takes place. The CPU is the brain of computer system that provide computational and decision making power. The CPU handles all the instruction it receives from various computer hardware component and also from the software application running on the computer system. The CPU chip is placed on the motherboard. Into a processor socket with looking lever mechanism. The processor chip is firmly placed into the socket on the motherboard. A heat sink is mounted on the top of the processor chip, which protects the processor chip from the excessive heat generated. Each CPU is made up of millions of tiny transistors. Each transistor functions are like a switch, which can be on or off. The central processing unit is divided into three: ALU, arithmetic logic unit, CU, control unit, and memory unit. Inside the memory unit, there is a cache memory and register. What are registers? Registers are small memory inside the CPU which stores the digital information. Instruction set architecture. Instruction set architecture is a set of instructions in binary code implemented by the CPU microarchitecture. This instruction can be directly interpreted and executed by the CPU. ISCA is a set of instructions in binary code implemented by the CPU microarchitecture. This instruction can be directed, interpreted and executed by the CPU. CPU instruction cycle or machine cycle. The CPU instruction cycle is executed sequentially and each instruction is processed by CPU, which consists of following step: read an instruction from memory, decode the instruction as per opcode, find the address of operand, retrieve an operand, perform the desired operation, find the address of destination memory, store the result in destination memory. The four main steps in central processing unit are fetch, decode, execute and store. These four forms the instruction cycle of CPU. Let us learn about new printing technology is called as 3D printing. The following process of 3D printing. The first step in 3D printing is to create the blueprint of an object you want to print using computer. Step 2. The finalized drawing is imported in some special software that prepare it in a format that is understood by the 3D printer. Step 3. The 3D printer is set up to allow the solid object to be made. Step 4. The solid object is built by layer by layer. This can take several hours depending on the thickness of the layer, the material used and size of the final object. Once again, the first step in 3D printing is to create the blueprint of the object you want to print using a computer. The finalized drawing is imported into some special software that prepares it in a format that is understood by 3D printer. The 3D printer is set up to allow the solid object to be made. The solid object is built up layer by layer. This can take several hours depending on the thickness of the layer, the material used and size of the final object. The 3D printing technology is changing the way we produce objects from tools and toys to clothing and even body parts. The 3D printing is a part of process known as additive manufacturing, where object is created by adding material layer by layer. Additive manufacturing allows designers to create complex parts of machines, aeroplanes and cars. The most common material used in 3D printing is plastic, but use of other materials allow for the creation of some amazing products. 3D printing is became very popular even in food industries. In the medical world, doctor can 3D print small body parts like ears and nose by using a patient cells. Some surgeons have even tested 3D printed organs for transplants. Recently, China has 3D printed 10 houses in just one day at the cost of less than $5,000 per house. Let us recall what we learned so far. The full form of CPU is central processing unit. The definition of CPU: CPU is an electronic microchip of computer which is processing the data converted to information. It is brain of computer. It controls the control system. Features of central processing unit: CPU is considered as the brain of computer. CPU perform all type of data processing operation. The CPU has three components: memory unit, control unit and arithmetic logical unit. What is memory unit? It is used to store data or information. Functions of memory unit: it stores all data in instruction required for processing. It stores intermediate result of processing. What is control unit? The control unit controls the operation of all parts of computers. It is responsible for controlling the transfer of data instruction among other units of computer. ALU. ALU stands for arithmetic logical unit. The functions of logical section is to perform logical operations such as comparing, selecting, matching and merging of data. CPU is otherwise known as microprocessor. Vinod Ham is recorded as the father of Pentium chip for his valuable contribution to the development of Pentium processor. The CPU is one of the most important components within a computer system. The CPU works at the lightning speed and performs millions of calculations per second in order to execute any program. The CPU is the brain of computer system that provides computational decision making power. Instruction set architecture is a set of instructions in binary code implemented by CPU microarchitecture. This instruction can be directly interpreted and executed by the CPU. The instruction cycle of CPU is fetch, decode, execute and store. The following steps for the process of 3D printing. The first step in 3D printing is to create the blueprint of object you want to print using a computer. The finalized drawing is imported in some special software that prepare it in the form that is understood by the 3D printer. The 3D printer is set up to allow the solid objects to be made. Step 4. The solid object is built up layer by layer. This can take several hours depending on the thickness of the layer, the material used and size of the final object. Let us see how 3D printer works.
Physical object ah convert panni kudukkudiyadha 3D printer. இந்த 3D printerல மொத்தம் 7 types of 3D printing methods இருக்கு. இதுல முதல் வகையான FDM 3D printing, அதாவது ஃபியூஸ்டு டெபாசிஷன் மாடலிங் பற்றி பார்க்க போகிறோம். இந்த வகை 3D printerல ஃபிலமெண்ட்னு சொல்லப்படக்கூடிய பிளாஸ்டிக் வயரை எடுத்துக்கிட்டு அதை உருக்கி லேயர் பை லேயராக ஊற்றி நமக்கு தேவையான மாடலாக அது கன்வெர்ட் பண்ணி கொடுக்கும். இந்த வகை 3D printerல நம்மளோட 3D மாடலை நேரடியாக 3D printerக்கு கொடுக்க முடியாது. ஸோ அதை எஸ்டிஎல் ஃபார்மேட்டில் கன்வெர்ட் பண்ணி ஸ்லைசிங் சாஃப்ட்வேர்னு சொல்லப்படக்கூடிய Cura, Simplify, Craftware, Slice 3R இதில் ஏதாவது ஒன்றை பயன்படுத்தி 3D printerக்கு தேவையான G கோடாக கன்வெர்ட் பண்ணி கொடுக்கும். Q க்யூரா ஸ்லைசிங் சாஃப்ட்வேரை எப்படி ஸ்லைஸ் பண்ணுறதுங்கிறத பற்றி பார்ப்போம். முதல்ல க்யூரா ஸ்லைசிங் சாஃப்ட்வேரை உங்கள் சிஸ்டத்தில் ரன் பண்ணுங்கள். அது ஓப்பன் ஆன உடனே நம்ம எந்த எஸ்டிஎல் ஃபைலை ஸ்லைஸ் பண்ணுறோமோ அதையே ஓப்பன் பண்ணுங்கள். இப்போ பார்த்தீங்கன்னா நான் க்யூபை வந்து ஓப்பன் பண்ணுறேன். அதில் அந்த எஸ்டிஎல் ஃபைலை க்யூரில் வந்த உடனே நம்ம அடுத்து செட்டிங்ஸை பார்ப்போம். ஃபஸ்ட்டு பார்த்தீங்கன்னா லேயர் ஹைட், நீங்கள் எந்த எவ்வளோ ஹைட் நீங்கள் சூஸ் பண்ணுறீங்களோ அதை பொறுத்து வந்து குவாலிட்டி இருக்குது. இதில் 0.4 mm லேயர் ஹைட் கொண்டு போனீங்கன்னா ஃபினிஷிங் அந்தளவுக்கு இருக்காது, பட் ஆனால் டைம் உங்களுக்கு சீக்கிரமாக முடியும். ஸோ நீங்கள் வந்து எந்த அளவு சூஸ் பண்ணுறீங்கிறது உங்களை பொறுத்து இருக்குது. அடுத்து இன்ஃபில், இன்ஃபில் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா சாலிடாக வேணுமா இல்லை வந்து ஒரு பேட்டர்னில் ஹாலோவாக இருக்க மாதிரி வேணுமா அப்படிங்கிறத தான் இன்ஃபில் சூஸ் பண்ணேன். நான் வந்து 20% இன்ஃபில் சூஸ் பண்ணேன். அடுத்து சப்போர்ட், சப்போர்ட் எதுக்குன்னு பார்த்தீங்கன்னா டிஃபிகல்ட்டான பார்ட்ஸை பிரிண்ட் பண்ண சப்போர்ட்ஸ் தேவைப்படும். இந்த மாதிரி க்யூபுக்கு தேவைப்படாது. ஸோ அதனால் நான் வந்து அதை வந்து கேன்சல் பண்ணுறேன். இப்போ அடுத்து எஸ்டிஎல் மாடலை ஜி கோடாக கன்வெர்ட் பண்ண கீழே பார்த்தீங்கன்னா ப்ரிப்பேர்னு இருக்கும், அதை வந்து கிளிக் பண்ண உடனே ஸ்லைஸ் ஆகி நமக்கு தேவையான ஜி கோடாக மாறிடும். அதையே சேவ் பண்ண கீழே வந்து சேவ் பட்டன் இருக்கும், அதில் நம்ம மெமரி கார்டுக்கும் சேவ் பண்ணிக்கலாம் இல்லைனா கம்ப்யூட்டர்லேயும் சேவ் பண்ணிக்கலாம். ஸோ அதை கிளிக் பண்ண உடனே சேவ் ஆயிடும். அந்த சேவான மெமரி கார்டை பிரிண்டரில் கனெக்ட் பண்ணி பிரிண்டரில் சூஸ் பண்ணி நம்ம ரன் பண்ண உடனே அந்த க்யூப் ரன் ஆகும். இப்போ பார்த்தீங்கன்னா தெரியும் அந்த க்யூப் வந்து ரன் ஆகுது. இந்த முறையில் தான் எப்படியும் 3D பிரிண்டருங்க ரன் பண்ணுறாங்க. ஸோ அடுத்து வரக்கூடிய
Thank you.